we're going to do the best that we can to lay down the best prayers we know how to put down for our future generations. And we appreciate all the people for coming in and being here with us and standing with us. You know, the next 4 days, there'll be more people coming too. And the best we can do is hoping and praying and putting a voice out there for goodness. I mean, that's all we're asking for, is a good way of life. This is for the land, this is for the water, for the fish, for young girls to become women. And that's what we're standing for. That's what this is about. Our rights as indigenous peoples, our rights as California Indians, to practice our way of life. This fire wanted to go, and it lit up so quickly that, you know, we've got a lot of good blessings coming our way. And if this happens here, then it'll be a good thing for all the Indians, especially in California, to be able to hang on to their traditions, to be able to go along with their life the best way that we can, because we're all recovering from a very horrible history. We're all recovering from a Holocaust that happened. No California Indian escaped that. But now, you know, we're waking up. We're taking back those things that belong here. These sacred fires belong here. This is a nonviolent issue that, you know, like I told them, it's like, we're not protesters. We're not activists. We're California Indians trying to carry on our traditions. And we're forced into this position of not having any other way to do this. We have negotiated for the last 5 years to try to get this in place. We've tried to utilize every law, every avenue that might allow the Forest Service to do the right thing. Yet, we've come up empty-handed. And the government should not be allowed to discriminate against a certain group of people because they deem them not recognized. Even though they had before recognized us. We all have cards that say we're certified by the Bureau of Indian Affairs as being Indians and descendants of Indians before 1850. Now all of a sudden we're not anymore. And I'm sure that we're all gonna learn a whole lot. I'm not quite sure what the Forest Service is gonna learn, but hopefully they'll learn something too. Only wishing goodness for them. They are the land managers. Even though they're a little bit behind in their thinking about managing the land, maybe they could catch on really quick.
Sure.
Because like Graham says, you know, we're only here in a blink of time. We're the short timers. We only get to be here, you know, up to 100 years, some very lucky people. But most of us, we don't stay here that long. And right now, most of us Indians, we don't get to stay here much past 60 anymore. It's very rare that we'll have elders stay with us very much longer than that.